Hello, welcome back. We are still on the series Spiritual Weapon, and I'm so excited that this is the last part. This is the last episode. If you have been following us from the first part, I want to say God bless you. If you have not been following us, okay, you can check out our other videos, the previous episode. The link of the playlist will be in the description below, or you can click on the YouTube card right here so you can watch the previous video. We'll be talking about the warfare dimension of prayer. It's going to be very powerful. So we'll be wrapping up the whole episode, the whole series. So make sure you watch to the very end. Let's get right into the video. Welcome back. My name is Metobi from the Living Flames of Fire, a channel that was established and set up by the Holy Spirit to help you grow spiritually and to take you deeper in the knowledge of Christ. If you are a new viewer or you're not a subscriber, I want to advise you to click on the subscribe button. Subscribe to the channel and turn your notification by clicking on the bell icon so that when we release new videos, you'll be the first to be notified. Alright, today we're talking about the warfare dimension of prayer, and our anchor scripture is Ephesians 6 verse 18, which says, "Pray at all times and on every occasion in the power of the Holy Spirit. Stay alert and be persistent in your prayers for all Christians everywhere." Okay, this is to tell us that prayer is very powerful. Prayer is very, very important. As a Christian, for you to be able to engage your weapon, you need prayer. That is why prayer is coming now at the last part of this video, at the very last part of the text, because prayer is very powerful. Without prayer, you will not be able to engage your spiritual weapon. Your spiritual weapon will be very useless without prayer. Prayer is the bedrock that will hold your spirituality together. It's the foundation of everything. If you look deep into that scripture, you'll see that it says prayer in the power of the Holy Ghost. That's very powerful. That's something very interesting. That's something you must take note of. Many Christians, they are praying. They are praying in the flesh. They are praying physically. Their prayer is not yielding results. The devil is still attacking them. The devil is still messing up their life because their prayer is done outside of the Spirit. It's only the Spirit that enable us, empower us to be able to use our spiritual weapon effectively. Note, it is called the weapons of the Spirit, spiritual weapons. So if there's no Spirit to back you up, if there's no Spirit to enable you, that means you will not go anywhere. And I said in the last video that the devil is not scared of those who have faith or who can pray or who can know the word. He's scared of those who have the Holy Spirit backing them up, because the devil knows that he cannot subdue the Holy Spirit. And if you are praying in the Holy Spirit, by the power of the Holy Spirit, I can tell you that you'll be able to effectively use this weapon to their full capacity. Right now, I'm going to tell you why the devil is messing up so many Christians' life, even if they are praying for hours upon hours upon hours. Okay, the simple reason is because they are praying wrongly. They are praying the wrong way. Most of them are trying to cage the devil. Most of them are trying to bind the devil, to just cage him up, to lock him up. So many people are trying to cut the devil into pieces. So many people, when they pray, they just imagine themselves holding a gun, holding a machine gun and shooting the devil. All those things will not work. So many people, they are trying to call down fire from heaven so that the devil will get burnt. The devil will not be burnt. The devil cannot be caged or locked up somewhere. The devil cannot be sliced. The devil, you cannot shoot the devil to death. You cannot kill the devil. You cannot kill the enemy. Okay, going back to all I've been saying since the first day of this series is the ability to use the weapon effectively. When you are praying, the devil might come to you and fill your mind with doubt. That is when you should take up the shield of faith. It might come to you and say, "Oh, look, you are faced with this problem and that problem. You are going to die after you stand up from this place. How are you going to face that problem?" You are going to pick up what the shield of faith and tell the devil, "I'm standing by faith. I trust the Lord to the very end." The devil will come to you and will make you lose your peace in the place of prayer. You will not have any peace. That's why you should remember the shoes of peace, knowing that there is a peace that is given by God that can silence every storm in your life. The devil might come trying to attack your mind, trying to remind you of your past mistakes, of your sin. That is why you should remember the crown of salvation, the helmet of salvation, knowing that you have kingdom authority and all your sins have been forgiven. So that is how the devil attacks people in the place of prayer, but they still keep praying wrongly. They pray outside the scriptures. All they are saying is not scriptural, because they are trying to use their physical weapon to defeat the enemy, which is not so, which cannot be done. So we cannot defeat the enemy with our physical weapon or with our carnal weapon. It is practically impossible. It's only by following the things written in the scripture that we can only gain victory over the works of the devil, over the works of the enemy. So I want to change your prayer pattern, change the way you pray. Pray according to what is written in the scripture, and you will see that things will begin to change in your life. Now you must understand that the life of a believer is a life of prayer. You cannot live a successful Christian life, or you cannot live a victorious Christian life, when you refuse to pray, when you refuse to pull down your knee and pray. It is practically impossible. The devil will toy with your life. No matter how you have understanding about the scripture, you still need prayer to engage those knowledge to be effective, so that they will bring results. The only way you will see results in your Christian life is when you engage in prayer. Prayer is terribly powerful. Is very powerful. It is what can set you up above the works of the enemy. The devil knows those that are praying. He knows those that are engaging in prayer. So if you are not one of them, that means you will be toyed by the enemy. So even when things are bad, keep on praying. When things are not right with you, keep on praying. When you see that nothing is changing, keep on praying. You should not stop praying. It should be part of your everyday life. It should be part of your Christian experience. You should keep on praying until you see things change, until you see things happen. So the Bible says, pray in all season, pray at all time, pray without ceasing. So you should keep on praying according to the scripture. And I bet you, if you keep doing this, things will begin to change, and things will change for the better. Alright, that is it for this video. I'm going to be rounding up this series right here. We are done with this series. Glory to God. I hope you have been blessed. I hope you have learned something very powerful. I hope you have been enlightened. Alright, if you like this video, don't forget to share it to your friends and your family. If you have any question, or there's something you don't understand, or you want to ask a question, or you want to contribute to what I've said so far, you can drop it in the comment section. I'll be glad to go through it. Also, I did a video which I titled How to Pray with Fire. The video link will be in the description, so you can learn more about the works of prayer. I want to tell you that so many exciting things are yet to come, so please and please make sure you subscribe to this channel. We'll keep updating you about the things of the spirit. Thank you once again for watching. I'll see you in the very next video.